Hello, my amazing artist. How are you today? Yeah, I'm hearing that you're saying ready to create. Very good. Okay, so I really miss you. I mean, it has been just a couple of days, but okay. So as you remember, our last project in our beautiful art room was the Don't Let the Pigeon Drive the Bus. And then I read the book to you, and then you didn't let the pigeon drive the bus, which is a very good job. And now, and then after, we did a favor to our pigeon. We drove the pigeon and threw the pigeon in a party, which we drew some shapes, some lines, and then we threw some confettis with the watercolor. Now, today we're gonna do a little quiet book about the pigeon. Okay, so we're gonna make a book that three things that pigeon dream. As you remember, we didn't let the pigeon drive the bus, but we made a favor for our little pigeon, and then now we're gonna make another favor, and then we're gonna make a book that three things pigeon dreamed. Okay, it can be anything, but we're gonna make a little book. Okay, actually it's not a book, it's a zine. I'm gonna show you how to make a zine. It's a little book, but first, before that, let's look at this book. Okay, so Don't Let the Pigeon Drive the Bus, the title of the book, and a little illustration, a drawing. It can be a drawing or it just can be the title. And as you see at the bottom, it says Words and Pictures by Mo Willems. Okay, so and then here some other stuff, and this is the front cover, this is the back cover, and these are the pages. Okay, so in our book we're gonna be doing the same, but it's gonna be very tiny book because it is a zine. So let's write it. It's gonna be a zine. What is zine? Zine is a kind of book. Okay.
Want a break from the ads? If you tap now to watch a short video.
And what's the name of the book gonna be? Let the Pigeon.
Yes, really. If you tap now to watch a short video, you'll receive 30 minutes.
The ring. Okay, so let me show you a little example I created for you. Okay, so this is the little zine, the front cover, the back cover, and the pages. It's just the 8-page zine, 8-page little book. The first page, the second page, the third page, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth, which is the back cover. Okay, so the first cover, the front cover, back cover, and the pages. So we're gonna make a quiet book, which there is no words, there is no story inside, just the drawings, which means that a quiet book, you can create your own stories in each reading. So in each reading time you can create another story, or you can just tell the same story, or you can just look at the pictures and dream about it. So this is kind of a quiet zine we're gonna be creating with you. So you already know how to draw a pigeon, but we're gonna go over it, and then we're gonna draw together. I'm gonna show you how to make a zine, and then in this bubbles you're gonna be drawing three things that he dreamed. So the first thing I think was a bus, because our pigeon was dreaming that he's driving a bus. So I choose to do a bus, which I colored in a rainbow, right? I know you guys love rainbow a lot, so I colored it in a rainbow with crayons. If you don't have crayons, that's fine, you just need to draw. And then as you see, I made the patterns of rainbows all around my page at the background. Okay, so here I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 scoops of ice cream, which is a lot, and cherry on the top. So I design my background with the cherries. And here, which is another dream that, which is another thing that he dreamed, you can draw anything you think that he is dreaming. So you're gonna be drawing three things each page with the pigeon in every page. And then in every background, as you see, I'm using a different pattern, okay? What was pattern again? Lines or shapes are repeated in a way or however you like, but when we are doing the pattern, we need to use variety. What was variety? Let's go back to the first page. Variety was like using the same shape, like a circle, in different colors or different shapes. Okay, so this is variety, which makes our artwork more interesting. Okay, and then you can change the colors, you can color it, or you can leave it if you don't have your materials. That's fine. We just need to draw it, and then you're gonna submit it to Class Dojo. You can take a picture, or which is better, you can take a little video. You can record this when you're flipping your pages, when you're just, you can record yourself, and then I can show, I can see, you can show me, okay? So let's start our little zine, how to do a zine. Okay, so we're gonna be using a copy paper. A regular cup of paper, and then the first thing we need to do is we're gonna be folding our paper to make the little zine, the book, the little book, just like this. Okay, so if you think that is going so fast, you can just press pause, okay, and then you stop the video, or you can watch it again until this time, or you can just pause it, you can try to make until this time, and then you can press play, which is that one, okay, and then you can continue. So let's start. We're gonna fold our paper, and then we're gonna use the long side, and then we're gonna fold it into two, just like this. So be careful with the corners. So we're gonna hold it after we are sure that they're come together. We're gonna fold it into two like a hot dog, right? And then we're gonna open it. And then this time, we're gonna turn our paper. And then from this short side, we're gonna fold again. Let's be sure that our sides, and then we're gonna fold it like a hamburger this time, okay? And then we're gonna open it again. So now there is a center here. We're gonna fold it to the center again. And we're gonna do the same thing from this side. We're gonna hold it and bring it to the center. We're gonna fold it again. Okay, let's see what happens. So after we did it, so it's gonna be something like this, okay? Let's open it again. So you will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 sections, okay? Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna fold it again like a hamburger, not like hot dog, okay? So we will take our scissors this time, and be careful how you use the scissors. We are not running, we are not walking with the scissors, remember, from the art room. And then we, as you see here, now we're gonna make a little cut. We're gonna cut it until this center. So I'm gonna show you until where. So we're gonna cut, we're gonna stop here, okay? So we're gonna be following this line, and what we're gonna cut it just here. So we are all set. Now let's open it. So there is a hole here. Now we're gonna hold it like a hot dog this time, okay? And then we're gonna put it on our table. It's gonna be like this. So, see? A diamond shape here. Now we're gonna hold it from the sides and squeeze it. Squeeze it, and then folded like a book. So we are all set. Now we have our eight pages little book. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we're gonna be drawing our pigeon and let the pigeon dream. If you need to remember how we draw the pigeon, let me show you how we draw it. So we will be using any paper and a pencil. Remember, first thing we need to do is sketch. What was sketched before the real drawing, we need to draw a couple of times. Even though for this one, I made it some of other samples. As you see, I tried it, and then I did this, okay? So you can try. Don't worry if you think that, oh, I messed up. Do not think like that. We can mess up, don't forget. In the art room, what we say, we can mess up, we can make mistakes, but we need to learn our mistakes, like from our mistakes. Okay, so we're gonna to make a pigeon this big, I mean to fit in this page. So we're gonna put our finger again here, and then we're gonna go a little bit up. And then left, we're gonna put our dot here to make our pigeon. First you need to do with a pencil, and then after you be sure you can use a Sharpie or a marker or what material ever you have, you can use it. But first please draw with a pencil lightly to do the sketch. This is gonna be our pigeon's eye. And then it's gonna be the eyeball. We're gonna make another circle around it, okay? And then this is gonna be the eye. We're gonna make another circle for the head, okay? Remember how we did the neck? We're gonna make two lines from the top to the bottom. Whoop, whoop. Remember? Mm-hmm. And for the beak, we need to do two diagonal line from the outer circle. Whoop, whoop, okay? And then two semicircle or curvy line from here to there that our pigeon is just talking and asking for something. And then from this line, we're gonna make a line just like that, okay? From this line, remember how I show you in the smart board? You're gonna practice with your finger first, okay? After you get used to it, you can draw a semicircle from this line to that line. Okay, so we're gonna be making the same semicircle inside for the wings, just like this. And then our pigeon is coming out, he just needs some legs. Whoop, 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 whoop. Okay, and then the collar, don't forget. Now I'm gonna trace it with a Sharpie. I'm sure you're gonna see it better. So our eye, a dot, and another circle around it, and another circle which hugs the other circle, just like that. Remember, hugging circles. And then from this line, we're gonna make diagonal lines just like that, and semicircle lines to make the beak. Our pigeon's head is ready. And then two lines from the top. Whoop, whoop. The Sharpie's dying. And then the collar lines. Whoop, whoop. From this part to here, a line. Whoop, and another again. Practice with your finger before doing your with your marker. We're gonna make a semicircle or a curvy line. Whoop. And we're gonna do the same inside for the wings. Now you're gonna be making the legs. and we're ready to go. If you feel comfortable, let's make smaller version. So we're gonna make a little dot for the eye, and another circle, the hugging the dot, and another one hugging the dot, hugging the other circle, sorry. And then let's make the beak this side this time. Two diagonals and the curvy lines, okay? And then whoop, whoop, two straight line. And from this one or this one, doesn't matter, because I mean, this is your pigeon. You're gonna decide where you're gonna put the body, this side or this side. I decided to put this time here, okay? Whoop, and then another semicircle, the same semicircle, and then for the wings and crazy legs, and then the collar, okay? So let's practice a couple of times that you can understand how to do the pigeon smaller. Let's make a small one. Okay, with the cooler. Okay, so this is how we draw our pigeon. So again, if you think that it's so fast, please press pause. Pause the video, watch it again, or practice it, and then go on, please. And then after you're ready, press play, and then you'll be fine. So let's now do the pigeon. First, we're gonna write "Let the pigeon dream," and then we're gonna draw a pigeon here. Okay. Please first draw with the pencil. Okay. Then trace it, but for you to see, I'm gonna use my Sharpie because I know it's really hard to see when I use the pencil. So I'm gonna draw. Let's try to do the same. I'm gonna do gonna make it balloon here. The first page is ready. Oh, I forgot. You need to write your name here because this is your book. So please don't forget your name. Don't forget to write your name. So our cover page is ready. Now let's do the first page, which is so we're gonna be making three things that pigeon dream. So the first page gonna be the first thing that he dreamed. And the second part, because I did the bus here, and the second page gonna be the second thing that pigeon dream, and the third one gonna be the third thing that pigeon dream. So as you see here, I make bigger one, just the head and the neck and the wing. That's all, no body. You're not seeing the body, so that's fine. You can do the same, or you can just do the whole pigeon in every page. So I want you to do the three things that pigeon dream. So I did the bus, the cone, and I just leave it empty because I want to see your imagination. Okay, so I'm gonna be doing different things now. Let's draw the pigeon, the eye, a hugging circle, another hugging circle, and then the beak, semicircle. Okay, and then whoop, whoop, the neck, and just forget the chord.
Your student loans and save some money for when this happens.
Thanks for coming to my housewarming. Sorry, you're sitting on an ottoman yoga ball.
So you're gonna be drawing here the second thing with the pigeon, and then you're gonna be drawing the third pigeon. You can make this line here. And then the wing, and then he is dreaming of something else. And this page, the end page. Okay, so let the pigeon dream. He's dreaming the first thing here, the second thing here, and the third thing here, and the end. If you have some materials, please do color your book, okay? Please do make patterns as I show you here. You can use different colors. You can use a crayon, you can use a marker, you can use, like, you can make some shapes and lines, like we did. You remember we did the hearts? So how we drew the heart? We make an M and the V, remember? And then you can do some varieties, upside down, different color. This is your book. You're gonna decide what you're gonna do. An M and the V, remember. Okay? So, our book is ready, and I'm gonna show you a trick now. So, do you want to publish your first children's book? Okay, so here it is. Open your paper. As you see, just this page is full of drawing. In the back, there is no drawing. This means if you copy this like 10 times and then do the same thing like this, you will have 10 books. It's a self published book if you do that, and you can give your friends as your book. This is this book that you created, you illustrated the Let the Pigeon Dream book. Okay, so I really want to see your works. I really want to see your amazing works. And then there is another surprise for you.
Uh-oh. Hello, I'm the pigeon. Oh, I cannot wait to see your books. This books, I want to see your books. Oh, dear amazing artist, I am the puppet pigeon.
Yes, my amazing artist, so this is the pigeon puppet, so I did it for you. I'm gonna make another video if you want to do another video, if you don't want to do some extra stuff, extra art, so you can just use this and then create more. So please upload your books in Class Dojo. I cannot wait to see them. And the due date is Friday. Okay, this Friday. Love you all. Stay safe and do not forget to wash your hands.